Well, good morning. We're back in Middle Earth, and we are back in that session play that I failed the last time. We got back to the point where we need to start fighting with the cave claws, and this time we will not be going near any glowy water. Oh, and I did learn something. Nafni has a skill that I never used, and it's called Nafni Speed. Nafni's ability to sprint at great speed surprised many of the long-beard brethren. Now, we're not going to use it in here, just in case I don't want to, you know, go in green water by accident and fail again. But, and trust me when I say it's fast. In fact, I don't even think the hunter with their own speed skill maxed out is as fast as this. Are we lagging? Oh, come on. Really? Really, we're lagging. Right now. It's like I'm not supposed to be doing this or something. Okay. Alright, we're back. I was wondering if I was going to be able to finish this. Actually, you know what? Let's go back here. I'll show you his speed skill. Ready? Go. And like I said, it's really fast. And it lasts for 30 seconds. And the cooldown's 30 seconds. So you could conceivably constantly use this throughout the whole instance. So we need to find one more claw. Ah, he's over here. And there's a cave wall over here. Alright, so I guess we go back to Doran. Now would be a good time to use that. Very good, my friends. And now we will show the elves the great bounty of mithril that still lies beneath Khazad Dûm. Follow Doran the Sixth and his company. I think this is supposed to be Doran the Fourth, isn't it? I think they messed that one up. I'll have to look. I know I said that last time and I totally forgot to check. Help him break through this wall, Nafni. Let's show the elves that our supply of mithril will not fail. You must face target. Okay. Help break through. Oh, okay. Right. You do not have permission to use that. You must face the target. Okay. I keep saying you must face the target. How much more facing the target do I need to get? I do not have permission to use that. Ugh. Invalid target. There we go. Just had to click on the right thing. That did it, Nafni. What manner of beast? And this is their discovery of Doran's Bane, the Balrog, the Lord of Fire and Shadow. Nafni, protect my son. He must rule Khazad of Doom now. Oh no, Nafni, we're trapped. Stay here, Nafni. It is Doran's command that thou must live. Escape. Okay. Use that. Wall of Sunning collapse, the way out is clear. This way, run. Doom upon the halls of the dwarves. The terror pursues us. What was that terror? I have never seen its like. It is the terror from another age, a Balrog of Morgoth. A thousand curses on the greed of dwarves. It should be slumbering still. What of the fabled courage of the elves? I did not see thee stand against the shadow. Thou hast doomed thyself, and thy kingdom will perish. I shall warn the sylvan elves to flee ere this evil spirit spills from thy gates. We must retreat, Nafni. We have no other option, but I swear on my father's name that I shall slay this Balrog, this ancient evil, this horror from a distant age. Khazad of Doom will not fall. I cannot die here. Nafni, slow its pursuit. And of course, that's the end of the session play. And that just shows the story of how the dwarves delved too deeply into Khazad of Doom and awoke the Balrog. And it shows kind of some of the ill will between the elves and the dwarves, although that ill will has been around for a while.
These halls will be great once more.
Beaunain and his kinsmen stood against the great evil that slew Durin. They did not stand long. Nain was killed by the shadow the following year, and the dwarves were forced to abandon Khazad of Doom. Many of the sylvan elves departed Lothlorien in anger and fear, flying southward and cursing the dwarves as they went. Thank you for listening to the tale, my friend. You see now the importance of this expedition to my people. Alright, so, having done that one, we are going to head back to the Chamber of Crossroads, and
the
we're going
to
do
the orcs from our kingdom.
The session play that we're up against, which is part of the epic story. And I will be right back. Okay, we're back. I had to look that up. So, they were right. It was Doran the Sixth. that was raining during the time when the Balrog was uncovered. His son, Nain, did escape, but unfortunately died a year later, leaving Thrain the First to lead the dwarves, who gave life to Thorin the First, who passed on the legacy to Glowin, a different Glowin, who passed on the legacy to Owen, a different Owen, who passed on the legacy to Nain the Second, who then passed it on to Dane the First, who then passed it on to Thror, Thorin Oakenshield's grandfather. So, that was actually a much longer family tree than I was expecting. So, yeah, but Thorin Oakenshield is indeed directly related to Doran the Sixth, about, I'd say, 6 or 7 or 8 greats in front of that grandson thing. And Thor actually was not quite as bad as the stories would have it, although he was greedy. He did try to redeem himself by attempting to go to the doors of Moria to fight the leader there to retake Moria. Unfortunately, he met his untimely end, and a dwarf named Nor, who had gone with him, saw what happened, ran back to Thrain the Second, which was Thorin Oakenshield's father, and Thrain the Second mounted an assault against the orcs in vengeance for his father's death. Okay. Pretty interesting and lengthy dwarven history. I'm going to have to read some more dwarven history because it's actually quite interesting and full of tales of glorious battles and great exploits and, of course, great defeats. But now, we cannot get out. The final moments of Balin's expedition lost many years ago in Moria. It's time for another session play. And let's try to do this one without failing it. That one is not a guarantee. It did used to have a pretty bad bug in it, which I believe has finally been fixed, or was finally
Alas,
fixed.
Alas, that Balin, son of Fundin, believed he could reclaim Moria, but with a small force. As the Company of the Ring learned, the number of the orcs and the might of Durin's Bane could not easily be turned aside.
Alright, so, let's fix this. Once again, I want to make sure I'm not throwing any skills off in the middle of battle. Move. Move that over there. Move that over there. Move that over there. Actually, we're going to move the Horn of Triumph to the front. Not necessary, but actually we'll move it up here. Oh no, and I just accidentally threw it off. Okay. Horn of Triumph, right there. We want that one. Trust me, we want that one. Now this particular character is closest to a champion. Because you have your champion skills, you got your blade barrier, you have relentless attack, you have blade fury, ferocious strike, and headbutt. Actually, we're going to move headbutt in front of ferocious strike. All right. Yes, I know. But now we're prepared. For our Captain Ori, you have arrived at last. I feared we would be overwhelmed before you arrived, but with your strength, we may yet push back the orcs. Oh, that Balin were still alive. We have need of his leadership against the horde of orcs. We must move with one mind, or we will not survive the fall of evening. I was cut off from Loni and Nali during the last attack. We must join them on the far side of the bridge, but many orcs have crawled up from the pit and stand between here and there. We must defeat them before yet more arrive. Alright. And we get to see the Bridge of Khazad-dûm in all its glory. And we even get to cross it, because this is before it breaks. Let's try not to fall off of it, though. Although you can actually get orcs to fall off of it. I've done that before. It's funny. Like that. And that's what the Horn of Triumph does. It pushes mobs away from you. Unfortunately, the skill does take some time to reset. All right. There's Loni and Nali. At last. Were we wrong to come back to Khazad-dûm, Captain? With Balin slain, this endeavor seems ready to fall. The orcs are too many. No, no. We will stand. I will die a dwarf. Let none call Noni coward. Things are not well, Captain. There is no end to the creatures. For every arc we cleave, two more spring from the darkness. Still, we are dwarves of Khazad-dûm. We will not let these arcs drive us from the halls in which we have lived for years. Too few. We are decided, then. One last glorious stand against the arcs. I weep that none will sing of it, Captain Ori. But I am glad that I have such honorable and dependable dwarves by my side for its making, for Balin, for Khazad-dûm, and for the glory of the dwarves. She's supposed to be protecting Frar. Look to the right. These are the dwarves that are actually moving as one. We are turning the tide against them. Forward, forward. And that is the long hallway down the first hall. That there is, of course, the second hall. Okay. Enough sightseeing. I do not like this, Captain. Some shadow lies ahead. How may my hand trembles, and I have never quailed before any foe. A great evil waits down this passage, worse than all the evils we have seen this day. I do not think we can face this thing. We must retreat. We must fall back. We must escape across the bridge. And, of course, that would be the Balrog. Once again, we are running away from the Balrog as fast as our little short dwarf legs could carry us. And that was another thing that used to be a little bit of a problem in this session play, is that the Balrog could catch up with you. Now, with some finesse, you could actually defeat the Balrog, but it was very, very, very difficult. More times than not, you would just fail the session. And I'm sorry, but there would be no amount of finessing to get me across this bridge. Well, maybe except that Balrog. Even I would probably want to quick bring Captain Ori back to 21st Hall. We have to get you out of here, Captain Ori. We must retreat to the 21st Hall and hope that we can hold them off there. I was not certain you would still be alive, Captain Ori, but I rejoice to see you. So, I wanted you here for our last defense. We are still waiting for word from the scouts you sent west, but so far there has been nothing. And now the Orcs have taken the bridge and the second hall and close in on our position from all sides. We are certain to follow Freyr and Loni and Nali, my captain, even if we hold out for a little while. Hark, who is that? Is that one of the scouts? It is. He has returned from the West Gate. My captain, I bring sad news. The pool has come all the way up to the walls at the West Gate. There is no hope of escape that way. Noble Oin's mission has ended, and in failure. In surprise, he was taken by the Watcher in the water, and the weapon he bore availed him not. The surrounding halls are filled with orcs, Captain. It was all I could do to make it back here, but it has been for nothing. What can we do? It's hopeless. There must be something we can do, right, Captain? What can we do, Captain? We have no hope of standing against them here in the hall. They will overwhelm us with their vast numbers. Billy listens as you to your plan, and his face hardens, his eyes stern and bright. You are right, Captain. We will retreat to the Chamber of Mazar Bul and make what stand we may. There we may last long enough to make them feel the sting of our axes and hearken our battle cries. To the Chamber of Mazar Bul, this is where we will make our stand. Captain Ori, I would have a word with you while we bar the doors and prepare. Now that it comes down to it, Captain, I grieve that our return to Moria has been so brief and so full of sorrow. Was Balin wrong to lead us here and to expect that whatever curse lay upon these halls had been lifted? It is too late now to ask such things, but I would not have this hopeful journey come to such an end, to be forgotten forever, to come to nothing. Captain Ori, I beg you finish writing our account in the book where such things are recorded. There it is, on the tomb we erected for Lord Balin. It was begun by others, but I would have you finish it. I do not want our fate to be forgotten. The Book of Mother Bull. And there it is. That is one thick, hefty volume. That's a lot of reading. All right. It is time to finish writing the story of the fate of Balin's company. Death to the orcs. And of course, just as soon as you get done, the orcs come. You're stubborn, Maggot Beard. But I, Mazog, will send you back to your maker. I never had a chance. He would have beaten Mazog if Mazog had been a an honorable type of creature who didn't call in all his buddies to attack. But, well, we're talking about Mazog, an orc. They aren't honorable creatures. And he did call in all his buddies to help him out. And actually, they not only have fixed the bugs in that, but I think they made that a little easier. Okay.
I do not know if things will be different this time. We must prepare for the storm.
If there is hope to be found in the leaves of Mother Bull, Medriel, I could not see it. If we are to survive where Balin's dwarves did not, we will need to prepare for the coming storm. It may not be possible, but we will at least make a stand.
The company of Balin, son of Fundi, came to a foul end in the dark halls of Moria. Durin's bane is gone, but many orcs still dwell within those halls. Can the returning dwarves maintain their hold? The orcs prepare for war, and the dwarves must do the same.
We must make the Chamber of the Crossroads ready for war. We must make the Chamber of the Crossroads ready for war.
I fear that we will meet the same fate as Balin's expedition if we do not prepare for battle, Medriel. If Ashpar is to be believed, the vengeance of Mazog, his host, may be swift. We cannot rest until we are prepared for the worst. We must be ready to meet this onslaught, and if we are lucky, we will not be doomed as Balin was, whose road was yet unknown to him. My dwarves, Slothi, Sigdon, and Thalfi, live in the Chamber of the Cross, here in the Chamber of the Crossroads, must be told the situation. You should do anything they ask to help them prepare for the coming storm. The Great Delving, at least, will be ready. Alright, so, here's Slothi. Appropriate name for somebody who's been sitting here on his butt the whole time.
Hear me out, friend! I have a tale of glory to tell.
Bozzi has tried to keep it quiet, but rumor travels quickly in the passages of Moria. Most of us are now aware of Balin's end. They were surrounded, orcs from the east and below, and the terrible creature in the pool by the Holland Gate. We cannot afford for that to happen again, Medriel, but if it does, it is my responsibility to make sure that we have enough supplies to withstand a long siege. I want you to leave Moria and speak to Thokmir, just outside the doors of Dorne. Tell him to send us as much food as he has to spare, and to arrange for more on a regular schedule. We will not be put in the same dire place as Balin's company. I would see us avenge them, so they may then rest in long peace beneath the stone. Alright, so there's Thalfi.
Stand and speak with me. The fate of Khazad Dûm hangs in the balance.
I do not like that. Well, I looked down upon it. I looked down it and couldn't see the bottom, but I'm pretty sure there's water down there. It makes me nervous. What if the orcs find the bottom of the well and try climbing up? They could use it to get into the room without the sentries noticing. I don't need to tell you what a disaster that would be. I'd feel better if you could find the bottom of the well and make sure there's no way for the orcs to climb up into this chamber. Melmer went looking for it, but I never heard back from him. I don't know how you'll get to the bottom safely, but you should find a way down to Waterworks and then look for Nirag Kalab, the bottom of the well. I expect you will find it southwest of the mighty aqueduct in the depths. Don't jump down the well itself, though, unless you think you could fall for uncounted fathoms and land alive on your feet. And here is Dor. Oh wait, no, we don't want Dor, we want Sigdon.
We have little time to speak. Great events have been set in motion.
Do you think we will be ready by this time the orcs attack us? I do not know if we will. If the orcs know how vulnerable we are now, they would not delay. They would attack us within the very hour. My cousin Spar has taken it upon himself to scout the approaches to the Chamber of Crossroads. If the orcs have any plans to attack soon, he will see the signs and can warn us in time. Please go help him with his patrol. I'm anxious for Spar to have some assistance should any unsavory foe meander across his path. And Morris has summoned you to his presence to further your training as Runekeeper. And he is down in the Foundations of Stone. We will not worry about that at the moment. Alright, we'll start with Spar, because he is actually not that far away from us. And here he is.
I am not sure Khazad Dûm can be restored. The orcs have surely ruined it.
If you're of keen eye and strong of arm, I would welcome your company on my patrol, Medriel. Let us scout for any sneaking orcs that might think to gain some advantage by spying on the approaches to the Chamber of Crossroads. Stay alert. Orc spies could be anywhere. Orc spy, don't let him get away. You have accompanied Spar on a patrol. A job well done. Tell Sigdon what help we were. Alright, so let's go talk to Sigdon and tell him his brother or cousin, I can't remember which, is okay. And that he's dealing with the Orc spies quite nicely.
Dwarves must fight for dwarves.
You did well, and I am pleased that you were there with Spar when he ran into trouble. My cousin is valiant and brave, but some challenges are simply too much for a single dwarf. Thank you, my friend. Perhaps we will be ready in time after all. Alright, so that's the first one. Now, before we do the second one, which
to drive forth the orcs from our kingdom,
is over at, well, the entrance, we are going to go back to the 21st Hall, because I think I've shown you this once before, a long time ago. Probably when we entered Moria. But if you come over this way, and you go down the hallway and to the Chamber of Mazerbul, and pass this dwarf here, you will recognize this poor unfortunate fella. That is Captain Ori. That is the dwarf we were just playing in the session play. So, a moment of silence for Captain Ori. Okay, he wouldn't want us to mourn over long. He would want us to go ahead and do what we need to do to protect Moria and defeat the orcs in his honor and name. Now, we are headed to the entrance of Moria. So, we're going to go to the stable master.
The time has come to drive forth the orcs from our kingdom.
We are going to Dolvin View. And from Dolvin View, we will head to Thorn's Threshold. Orthelion of Gondor. Oh, pretty good name.
The Shadow of Mordor will not long fill the halls of Khazad-dûm.
It is nice to see a name that somebody created that looks like it is belongs in the world of Middle-earth. You know, we do have people on this server that have some pretty odd names. I mean, I have somebody who names his character Shopkeeper and Vault whatever. Vault Mule or something like that. So, yeah, we do have those now. They do not follow the naming constraints that they used to on this server. I tend to give my characters, even my grinder characters that I use to get Lotro points, I still try to give them appropriate names. Just because. You know, I'm not the type of person that's going to name a character XX Deathstalker 5000XX. Yes, I've seen names like that. Not on this server, though. On places like Brandywine. And we approach Doran's Threshold. There aren't really, I mean, for the fact that there are a lot of dwarves in Moria, there aren't really a lot of dwarves in Moria compared to all the orcs in Moria. And through the door. I believe the dwarf we need to talk to is just right there.
Welcome to Khazad-dûm.
So the trouble with Moria has begun already. I'm not surprised that they have come, but I did not expect that they would be upon us so soon. I would have urged more caution, but I held my tongue. Bozi and Broger are capable dwarves, and I did not wish to heed the warnings of my heart. I approve of the decision. In order to increase frequency of delivery into Moria, I have long said that food has been too slowly sent into the mines, for any number of obstacles could besiege our supplies within or outside of the mines. I will give you the first of these deliveries. Bring it to Slothy in the Chamber of Crossroads and tell him that more will follow. All right, so we have a supply of food. I don't know where we're holding that at, but for the sake of argument, we've put it in the goat saddlebags or something.
The Lords of Moria have returned.
And we might as well just go take the goat straight from here to Chamber Crossroads, since that's where we're headed. But yeah, as many dwarves as you see roaming around various parts of Moria, there aren't a lot of dwarves compared to the number of orcs that we see in Moria. So they are in real danger. And we're going on a wild goat ride. As you can see, it just bounced into a wall. Let's just hope it doesn't bounce off a bridge. That would be, you know, really nice. Let's stay on the bridges. Let's stay on the path. Kind of, mostly. We got some goblins hanging out here. And he's salivating at the chance of killing a dwarf or three. Okay. I was going to say, please turn. It did. Madame. I love how the Deepclaw just walked right past that guard, and the guard doesn't even blink. Neither does the Deepclaw, actually. You would think in some areas of the game, like where the Bjarnings live, if a mob comes too close to a settlement, the Bjarning guards will actually attack it. And, yes, usually defeat it. And there are some places, like, there is a field. It is near... Isengard? Kind of roundabout near Isengard, but it's a field full of purple flowers, and it's constantly getting attacked by like Dunlanders or something, and there are actually guards there that will fight. You can also sit there and fight too. Used to be you could hang out there and fight a lot of mobs and get all sorts of legendary items. I don't think that's a thing anymore. But yeah, that used to be a spot to go and grind for legendary items that you could break down for the shards you needed to upgrade things and all that good stuff. But the point being is that some NPCs will fight mobs when they get close. But most of the time, they don't. It was just kind of weird. Okay, that's Thathly. We haven't done his yet. There's Slothy.
Greetings, friend. Are you lost?
Ah, the first of several deliveries from Thorgrir, I hope. Good, good. We won't be shut off from the outside world and caught unawares this time. We will be ready for anything. Alright, so. And we have a new title. We have completed Kendrit with the Iron Garrison Guard. Which means, from this point on, any rep items we get, we can either toss on the AH or toss over to a character that we have that we might need them. Now, he said don't jump down the well. Well, it's the fastest way to get there. And yes, we're going to die. But we'll at least end up at the Circle of Shame down at Waterworks and can run down to the bottom of the well from there. So I'm going to do this backwards. I usually do. So I don't have to see the actual jump. Yes, I know. I'm a wuss. Okay, ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Down the well we go. That was a deep well. And you have been incapacitated. Before we even hit the ground, we were incapacitated. That's funny. Sometimes, every once in a while, very rarely, you actually survive that fall. This wasn't one of those times. Alright, so, where are we? But like I said, it is the fastest way to get down to Waterworks for this quest, which is why we did it. You also get a title for that. I can't remember what the title is. Oh, here it goes. A new title has been bestowed upon you. You may now be known as Medriel Well-Traveled. Well-Traveled. Ba-dum-bum. We've also earned like 15. We should have earned more than 15. We've earned like 35 Lotro points today and we weren't even trying. Now we are looking for the spot we just died at. The bottom of the well. We shouldn't be too far away from it. No, we're not too far away from it at all. And of course, that's Gabble Munns up there. We've seen that. We have spent some quality time up there with the dwarves, helping them with their arc problem. There we go. We're almost there. Somehow I've amazingly managed to avoid every mob so far. And there he is. Melmar, hello.
Dark things dwell now in Moria.
This is it. Do you see the hole in the cave ceiling above us? That's the bottom of the well in the Chamber of Crossroads. I don't think we need to worry about Arcs climbing up, though. Oi, draw your weapons. And let's seek higher ground. Many foes approach. So, we're going to have to fight some things. There's some enraged flood blizzards. And luckily for us, Melmar is the type of dwarf that will actually help. Don't rest yet, friend. Here come some toads. Look out, lizards again. toads again. Get ready. Marauding toads. And yes, that toad just threw me. This is getting ridiculous. Here comes the big one. Oh wow, these toads are really liking to throw me today. You have defended Melmar from his foes. Tell Baffy he need not worry, this place is well protected by toads and lizards. Alright, so where are we here? Oh, we're right near the Valmont, so we can take the stable from the Valmont back. Yeah, because there's a great wheel right there. Okay. Okay. So that particular item is insubstantial. I was going to try to jump on top of it, but apparently you can't. It has no collision mechanics. Rohan is fine, except for some reason they expect to ride our food there. Ride our food? What? Do you eat horses? You're thinking of Mordor. Where you get battle pigs. Well, it's good to know that I'm not the only one that looks at those battle boar and goes, oh look, I get to ride dinner.
The time has come to drive forth the orcs.
Alright, back up to the rotting cellar. I figure it's probably just as fast to ride the stable goat back up there as it is to swim across everything to get back. Technically, Gondor is the one that betrayed the Dunlendings by ceding the land to Rohan without consulting the people who live there. Except that that piece of land never belonged to the Dunlendings to begin with. It always belonged to Gondor. So they're arguing about the Dunlenders. Oh, okay, let's get off here. Where's my... There we go. Okay. We are going to take a little side trip now. So we head down this way. And I showed you that this leads into the Flaming Deeps. This is the Burning Stair. That's an orc. We're going to ignore him. He's going to chase us, but he can chase us if he wants. And he also has, like, flaming arrows. Isn't that lovely? You have discovered the Crossroad of Ash. And we're going to keep going this way. You have discovered the Gate of the Seven Fathers. Another orc. He's going to chase us too. I don't care. We'll be doing some quests down here before long. Some fun stuff over here. Go across this. We got some dragonettes chasing us. Discovered Hadad-Mazer. Oh. Really? Excuse me. Rude little thing. And we're not going to worry about taking any side quests here right now. We'll be down here soon enough. Alright, so where are we? Right here. So we need to go that way. And on the way there, we're going to come up here because we're here anyway. We're going to kill these worms if they attack us. Which they won't. I managed to... Oh, wait. Nope, there they are. Okay. Grab this mirror. The inhabitants of the Flaming Deep seem to hate the mirror. They abhor the light it reflects, but the dwarves need that light, for it shows the way and makes it safe to explore and mine. Alright, so we have fixed this mirror. Now we can head to Nazarmekim. And at least turn that side quest in. Okay. Down. Cross this bridge. There's another area full of orcs there. But, like I said, we're not taking any side quests except the mirror. Back up. Not one of my favorite spots in Moria, but definitely rates way above the Fanged Pit. Alright, so who do I need to talk to about the mirror? Hello, excuse me, sir.
These halls will be great once more.
Thank you, Medriel, for realigning that mirror, although I suppose I shouldn't get too pleased yet, for I'm sure the creatures down there have already shoved the mirror out of alignment again. Now, I don't know how many mirrors I have left. Let's see, I don't think that shows up on the quest tracker, does it? Moria, Moria. Well, I see the riddles. Okay, so I guess each of these shows up in their own. Yep, because there's a glimmer of hope. A light in the garden. So each area has its own mirror. I have to figure out which mirrors I've done and which mirrors I still need to do. Durin's court.
The time has come to drive 40 orcs from our kingdom.
And we need to head back up to Chamber Crossroads. So let's take. Let's go 21st Hall, because from there's a fast stable up. There we go. For a second there, I thought I hadn't clicked it. It was just lagged. And like I said, some of these rides are wild. Some big, huge, wide hallways. And we got a glimpse of what it would have looked like in its prime when we did the Fall of Moria session play. It would have been bright and shiny and pretty impressive, to be honest. Now it's very dark and gloomy and crumbling. And of course, full of orcs. We'll have to go down the big hall of Durin and find the rest of those arc side quests. Because there's a bunch of them. You go from place to place and you have to clear things out. And of course there are a lot of pop-up quests through there. And we did say we were attempting to do all quests in each area. So, since I know that there are quests there that I haven't done, I want to make sure I get there to do them. He's got a quest even. We'll get to him, because going down the hallway will lead us to some of this. Eventually lead us to him, I believe. More Moria warriors. That's an area we'll need to explore. I know it has some quests. Now, out of these areas, there is one I always have a little bit of trouble finding. That ain't it. Should be fun. There are either two or three more pockets of orcs, orc encampments. The Great Hall of Durin. We're almost there. And then we'll go talk to Balfi. For a second there, I thought we were going to get permanently stuck on that pillar. Still amazes me they took the long way around to get back to 21st Hall. There were easier ways to do that. We're almost there. Some impressive stone, if you think about it. It's like some sort of marble, agate, and we're back in the 21st Hall. I was gonna say the safety of the 21st Hall, but at this point, I don't think any part of Moria is truly safe. Alright, so Chamber Crossroads. Okay. Now let's go talk to Balfi.
Shadow of Mordor will not long fill the halls of Khazad-dûm.
You say that Melmor found the bottom of the well, and that he is confident that the orcs cannot climb it? That is good news. I am less worried now about its presence. We may do all right after all, my friend. Thank you for investigating this for me. So we have helped all these fine dwarves. Let's go talk to Bozy again.
I hope we have done enough, friend.
You have indeed done as I asked. Now I can but hope it will be enough. The great delving, at least, is sufficiently at the ready. We were fortunate that Mazog had not yet made his move. So we can pick, I guess, Slothy's hat, which isn't really all that much better than what we're wearing.
The dwarves at the Heart of Fire must prepare for an attack.
My heart dares to hope that we will be prepared for when the orcs mount their attack. There is still time in which to prepare. We must make the most of it. Travel to the Way of Smiths among the Silver Time Lodes and lend your aid to the dwarves working in the Heart of Fire. The hammer blow may fall hardest there if Mazog were to learn the importance of these forges to our continued maintenance. Skothical is in charge of the efforts there. Go to him with my commendation of your merits. Alright, so our next step will be to go to the Heart of Fire.
These halls will be great once more.
So we're going to head to Dolvenview, and next time when we pick up, we'll be at the Heart of Fire, and we'll talk to Skothkel and see what he needs. But until then, bye for now.